And now we're going to learn how to make invoices for earned income from attorney services. What happens at the end of each month? Well, income from legal fees goes up by the amount of retainer that was prepaid and earned during the month. But if income from legal fees goes up, by that same amount, unearned retainer fee should go down, because now you have less money unearned because you actually earned it during the month. What happens to the client's balance? Well, in this case, the client's balance will go down, because if you actually earned some of the money that the client prepaid for, then you owe the client less money in future services. For example, January 31, let's create invoice number one for our client, Alan Arby, for the fees Ross earned during January. We know that's $1,000 a month, because in the previous video, he prepaid $6,000 in retainer fees for six future months. Now, one of those months has gone by, which means Ross has earned $1,000. So this is how you record the invoice. You click invoice from the icon bar, choose Alan Arby, the client. The date is the end of the first month, which in this case is January 31 of 2017. Now, the only item that you have to put on this invoice is the fees earned item that you actually set up in the first video. And you have to put $1,000, because you can see this invoice is for the end of January, which means during January, Ross earned $1,000. Now, when we click save and close, and click, don't worry about this message, just click yes, and okay, cancel, we'll talk about that pop-up in the next video. But right now, let's take a look at the trial balance. You can see unearned fees has decreased by $1,000, and income from legal fees has shown up in the trial balance for the first time as $1,000. You may also notice that in the client balance detail, Alan was owed $6,000 in future service on January 1, but then on January 31, Ross declared that he actually earned the income of $1,000, which was 1/6 of the payment, and that means as of January 31, Ross owes to Alan only $5,000, because $1,000 was earned during January. Now, what about our other retainer client, Betty Boop? January 31, we also declare that we earned Betty's January retainer the same way. And we remember from the previous video that Betty paid us $7,200 for 6 months in advance, which means during January, Ross earned $1,200 from Betty, and he will acknowledge that by making an invoice. Again, we click invoice from the icon bar. This time, the client is Betty, and the date is already set for January 31 of 2017. Again, the only item you have to put on the invoice is fees earned, but in this case, it's $1,200 that Ross earned from Betty during the month. I also should mention at the bottom of the window that you cannot see, there's another memo field where you can describe every last detail of this invoice and how it relates to everything else. When we click save and close, we can take a look at the trial balance, and now you can see actual earned income from legal fees has increased to $2,200 and unearned retainer fees has decreased to $13,400. If you ever wonder why the balance is the number that it's showing, anytime you see a total amount in a report, you can always double-click and get the detail. So here we can double-click the total of income from legal fees earned and see it's because of these two invoices that were recorded on January 31. You can also double-click the $13,400 of unearned retainer fees to see why that is the result. When you double-click, You get a detail of every single transaction that has led you up to the balance of $13,400. Notice the first three payments that went into unearned retainer fees increase the balance, and then notice the two invoices that we recorded when we actually returned it, when we actually earned it, decrease the balance. And this is the explanation. And of course, just like in the previous example, when you open the client balance detail, you can see that we now owe Betty only $6,000 in future service because we earned $1,200 during the month. So this customer balance detail, which is also called the client balance detail, shows you every event that changes the balance, and it shows you the running balance, which means the balance of what's owed to the client at any given moment in time. You may remember from the previous video that our arrangement with Candy is a little bit different. On February 2, Ross performed one of two prepaid services for Candy Charles worth $1,200. Make invoice number 3 and send her a paid invoice. Well, that's basically the exact same thing. Ross earned some of what was prepaid. But in this case, the invoice date will instead be February 2. And of course, QuickBooks automatically enumerates the invoice, and you could always highlight this and change it to whatever invoice number you would like it to be. The customer in this case, the client, is Candy Charles, and the only item you ever have to put on an invoice if you do not track your income for separate services, and the amount we earned in this case is $1,200. Now, at the moment we click save and close, of course the trial balance shows an increase in earned income and a decrease in unearned income. And of course the client balance detail shows that we now owe Candy less money as a result of the service that we performed on February 2nd.